Hi guys, welcome back to another Snapshot video. This time we have a new mob, a new block, new features and bug fixes, so a classic snapshot. First let's check out the new block. This is the so-called lodestone. So this is a non-movable block that you can use to readjust your compass. It's a bit expensive to craft, you actually need a netherite ingot and 8 chiseled stone bricks. So netherite ingot in the middle gives you the lodestone. Okay, so to readjust your compass, you just need to right-click the lodestone. At the moment, I'm in the overworld, so the compass is pointing towards the world spawn. The other two dimensions, the compass never worked, but yeah, it will with the lodestone. So if you have to right-click it, and it gives it the enchanted look. And now it would point towards this block here. Of course, you can also have a second lodestone block, and the second compass, click on that. So it could point to different points of interest. So could, for example, also use an anvil, rename your compass to, let's say, Enderman farm. Could have those in your Shulker box. And in case it's not entirely clear where a certain build is, you could use the compass to find it. In case you break the lodestone block, the compass needle just goes crazy. But you could, of course, reuse it again in case you have a second lodestone block and adjust it accordingly. This also works in the nether dimension and the end dimension as well. A compass that isn't in its dimension would have the needle spinning wildly. I think the lodestone is a pretty nice addition to the game. It's a bit expensive, but also totally worth it, especially exploring in the nether or end dimension. You can always find back to your portal. It was pretty cool. All right, moving on. Basalt is also now renewable, so similar to cobblestone. So the conditions to form basalt is you need to have lava on top of soul soil, and it has to have blue ice right next to it. So let's check it out. I'm gonna place lava source there. It also works with flowing lava, of course, and it would form basalt here. So similar to a cobblestone generator, of course, you could also make a basalt generator. It's definitely better to do that in the nether dimension, since lava flows 3 times as fast there, so every 10 ticks instead of every 30 ticks. That's also interesting in case you have water and blue ice at the block where the lava would flow to. It depends on the direction or the update order what you would actually get. So in this case, we're getting cobblestone. If I place another blue ice there, we're getting basalt. Alright, so I think this is a really interesting feature. You can now make basalt generators, similar to cobblestone generators. But now we actually have all the ingredients to play Skyblock in the Nether, I would say. So we can set our spawn point, we can use the compass in the Nether now, we can make a basalt generator. So yeah, Skyblock in the Nether would be quite interesting in my opinion. There are also a couple of changes to farmer villagers in this snapshot. For the first time, they are able to exchange wheat items directly with each other. All right, let's throw this guy stack of wheat. And I think we also have to adjust the time of the day. I think it only works at non-work hours. Then we should be able to see them exchanging some wheat items, if you're lucky. Maybe let's try... No, it actually happens. There we go. He's throwing the wheat out. And that's obviously interesting because we could steal that wheat using hopper minecarts. So we can now make fully automatic wheat farms with this mechanic. We were able to do that before, but we always had to have hopper minecarts below the farmland collecting the items. But now we could use the concept of the potato and carrot farm. We had one farmer villager doing all the work and then exchanging the items with another villager. For the wheat farm as well. You just need a second farmer villager, which is the important part here, to exchange the wheat items. And more cool things happening with the farmer villager. They're now able to use bone meal and also produce their own bone meal. So I could throw this guy a stack of bone meal, would pick it up. There's no inventory space for that, and can use that in order to grow the seeds here. See if it happens. It's a bit random what his next task is. Yeah, I probably need to be lucky to see that. Okay, now he harvested. It's hard to spot. But yeah, what he would also do is, in case he has some excess seeds, don't follow me, he can put those into the composter. You can see there's already, the composter is a filled up slightly. Excess seeds could be put in there, and once it's filled up, the bone meal can be taken out and used on the seeds. Okay, that happened again. He put some seeds into the composter. Really wish we could see them using some bone meal. I think you even see some bone meal in front of his... There we go! Yeah, in front of his body there was the bone meal item for a second. So it did just happen. In regards to farming and efficiency, the bone meal feature with the farmer villagers is probably not super important. It's just a nice detail. So you could also use a farmer now to put your seeds into a composter, but yeah, you can also use a hopper instead. Also the farms with the villager using bone meal now won't be much more efficient, but it's just a nice detail in my opinion. You can also of course also use a dispenser to bone meal the seeds. So it's mostly nice aesthetics. It seems like the farmer doesn't compost excess potatoes and carrots, but I've seen them composting beetroot seeds. Also really nice change here, the respawn anchor can now automatically be refilled, but not with a hopper, you actually need a dispenser. So as you can see, we got a stack of glowstone in there. Could fill it up completely. In case you keep triggering it, the glowstone doesn't get lost or spit out, it just stays behind in the dispenser. Okay, this obviously also allows us to automatically refill the respawn anchor in case we die, so in case we lose a level, we could detect it here with an observer and send a signal to another dispenser below. Okay, we could actually activate this and fill it up completely. Yep, this is Minecraft now. Meet the new Strider mob that spawns in the Nether Dimension. I think we actually have to take a moment to let that sink in. Alright, so what is this about? Those Strider mobs spawn in the Nether Dimension. They're actually animals, so they're non-hostile. They also spawn with the passive mob cap every 400 ticks. And you can actually ride them, breed them, so they're basically Nether animals. You can also saddle them and cross the Nether Lakes. Okay, let's actually go in creative mode real quick. Let's put a saddle on top of this guy. You can ride them and also lead them. If you craft a warped fungus on a stick, you can ride across the Nether Lakes. A lot of people have been requesting Nether boats. I think what we got now is actually even better. The Strider mob. This is actually too good. So the exact spawning conditions for those guys are they would spawn in lava below Y31 in each biome. You can also breed them. So we have two here. They also shake if they're not in lava because they're freezing. So you can breed them using the warped fungus to get a baby Strider. See? Yep. There it is. Alright, if you kill one of those guys, they would drop some string. Of course, you're thinking now, string farm, yay. It's definitely possible, but it would require quite a lot of effort and would also be not so fast, because they would only spawn every 400 ticks. Unlike normal hostile mobs, they could spawn every tick. So the farm wouldn't be that fast. People also already have found the first speed bugs. So this one was found by EasyEM. If you have a row of blocks here next to the Strider, you can accelerate to pretty high speeds. Unfortunately, after a couple chunks, you would slow down again. And also it seems like there's a limit how fast you can go with this. Probably will also be fixed though. We also have some changes to fishing in the snapshot. There are even more restrictions now to determine if you would get a treasure. We'll see if it's possible to still make an AFK fish farm. At the moment, we also don't understand it fully. Alright, another change is that lily pads would no longer prevent you from getting treasure. So in case you're fishing in a swamp biome, you don't need to worry about those lily pads anymore. Getting a soul speed book is also now easier. You're 5 times more likely to get it from the piglin bartering. That's also nice here. You can now get XP when mining the Nether gold ore. And one last thing, the way to obtain polished basalt got changed. Last snapshot, you had to smelt basalt in a furnace. That doesn't work anymore. you now have to use the stone cutter. So if you put in your basalt, you can click on that and craft it into polished basalt. Alright, that's it for today's snapshot. I think it's a really interesting one. Thanks a lot for watching. See you next time. Bye bye.